So we're gonna be making lasagna. I got a lot of stuff out and ready to go already, so I will, we're gonna just, we got the pasta water started, and we have another pot for the sauce, and then the other, this last pot is for the meat. And then we're gonna do a cheese combo. So, I got things to do. We're gonna, first of all, we gotta open this can. Cause I'm pretty sure we're gonna need it. That's the only one we needed the can opener for. Everything else is bottle or, I mean jar or pull tab. Okay. And we're gonna have to cut up some veggies and first we're gonna get this pasta sauce going. This is Bertoli's marinara, traditional marinara. We're gonna use one jar. It's 24 ounces of that. Gotta get my little secret thing out. These things weren't even made for this, but they work like a friggin' charm. It's amazing, right? Every time. And I don't even have to do it that hard. All day long it's been like this, all day. And let me just fall on my foot. Got tomato sauce all over my
Oh, my slippers are working. And my hands. On my brand new carpet. Of course.
Excuse me. Pasta sauce everywhere. Then we're going to put in the petite diced tomatoes with garlic and olive oil. And then this one is a classic Dicenia, you know, classic pizza sauce. And we're going to be putting that in too. Straighten those. Alright, we got some garlic already in here,
That'll work. Quite a bit of garlic in there. Okay. Huh. Interesting. I've never used this before. Filled the can in 5 hours. Really? Of September. September 1st, 2024. Wow. So, still good. All right, going in. All right. Where did it? Oh my goodness, almost went down the drain. Trying real hard not to get tomato sauce out of it. This over here now. Get a little stir. We might not even need any of that tomato sauce. I'm not that cooking with it. I'll let that cook a little bit. We're just going to set that aside for now. So I've decided the rest of the peppers are going to go into this recipe. Is what I have decided. I'm going to go ahead and put the rest of the peppers in the lasagna. They're in a bowl. Okay. Let's put those aside.
a green, and I believe that's an orange one. Maybe just another yellow one. I don't have much green left. We're going to use what we got. This is orange or if it's a yellow. It is a yellow. Okay. Uh oh. Top of it's bad. So we're going to go ahead and use what's not bad. I don't know, this is a lot of peppers. Maybe not so much. Anyhow, enough. Here. Go for a minute, and we're going to do this garlic. I bang this one on the floor. Okay. good. Carlos, that's all in the beginning. There we go. On my face. Didn't even get to use that one before it got stained.
Boy, these are little, yeah. I thought they would be this way. Not the other way. No, no. Right down a little bit. And down in there. And get in the pot.
down quite nicely, actually. That's going to be enough for garlic. All right, well, I'm having a hard time. My phone is overheating. Oh, this is the one. This is the one I've had for, I don't know, 3 days. Some shit like that. Anyway, so it's shutting itself off. It's quite pissing me off. So, we got some basil going in. It's still boiling. Sorry, grabbed the wrong thing. We're going to turn the temp down on this. Turn it way down to simmer. Alright. So we're going to put some basil in there. Parsley. Keep it stirring so it doesn't splatter me. Okay. Well, I'm getting there. We're going alright. We'll be alright. We turn the temperature down. Get some garlic powder. Salt. Noodles are done. It for those. I'll go ahead and put these in there. Roasted peppers. And I put the garlic in there as well. So I think the last thing you saw was me cutting the garlic. So we're in. Here's how I do this. I get my handy dandy really heavy duty glove. And I gotta put the big strainer in the sink. I'm gonna do that. Oh, and we gotta cut some celery to put in there too. Down. Stir it in. Oh, wait. Oh, I got a little bit left. A little tiny bit left. Okay. Got about a half a cup. There we go. I always forget. Okay, so burners are off. This one is going to have to sit right there. So I can put this one back on. Alright. I don't know about you, but I'm going to stop the cooking process on these noodles. So cold water. And if they're not cooked enough, the funny thing is you can just turn the water to hot, right? Leave them right in the strainer and just dump hot water on them and they'll finish cooking. But these are cooked to a good temperature. See, I knew these two were going to stick together. I can't have them sticking together. My goodness.
There we go. A little bit more.
There we go. We got those apart. And these will cook in the oven better as well. So Okay, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to grab this, and as I rinse them off, I'm going to put them in here. I'll put them back in the strainer, but I just want to get them all rinsed off. And I don't have to cook these anymore because they're going in the oven, so they're finished cooking in the oven. So I boiled them for 10 minutes, and they're at al dente. And then the oven will continue the cooking process just fine. I just don't like starch, so I'm rinsing the starch off of them. And they look good. And so far I've only found that one that was stuck together. Otherwise they were not even sticking together, which is a good thing. There's some little pieces stuck to some of them. Other than that, I think we're good. These two might be stuck together. Yeah, maybe. Yep. A little bit. There we go. That'll be fine. And I gotta keep them wet. I might just keep them in this bowl and then strain them out when I'm ready to make it. Because I'm not ready to make it yet. That sauce has gotta cook for a little while. Uh-oh. Oh dear. I got my sink almost overflowing here. Dang. Bang, bang, bang. Here we go. Wow. I am dumbfounded about some things sometimes. I mean, why is it all of a sudden clogged up like that? I didn't put anything down the drain but water. Like, I haven't used a garbage disposal for garbage in a long time. A couple of these are tore up a little bit, but I think that's to be expected. Alright. This lasagna is going to be so good. I got cottage cheese, pepper jack cheese, and cheddar cheese, and cream cheese, sour cream. I don't know about sour cream, but cream cheese for sure. Alright. We're just going to throw these pieces away. Set this right back in. Put that onto the side. Pour some cold water in there and let these soak in cold water. Okay, so now we're going to finish up. We're going to do the celery and then the hamburger. Let's see. I think all we have to do here is. Oil in there. get the celery in there. Looking good. I got itch on my nose. Sorry. Itchy on my nose. I didn't really put much in here. Sounds good. Put some salt. Some pepper. So, put the noodles back in there. We strained off the hamburger. I don't know where you left off. I just don't look up enough, apparently. My phone keeps shutting off. So we're done with that burner, so we're going to shut that off. Put the meat in here. It's good. All right, meat is in. Turn you around. Here's the sauce. So we're gonna mix in that hamburger. We're gonna get it good mixed in. The beef is in. Sauce is looking good. And then all we have to do now is mix up the cheese. Get that ready to go. Okay, so just got done washing my hands. And we're gonna assemble the lasagna, and so I've got the cream cheese already softened, and the cottage cheese. This is the bowl we're going to mix the cheeses in. So let's get something like this with knuckles. I don't know. So we're going to go ahead and use all the cottage cheese, except for maybe a bite or two. I'm going to go ahead and do my bite in here, which is just a little bite or two. I don't even remember cottage cheese tastes like. I haven't had it in so many years. So many years. Used to be really picky about cottage cheese. That's why I stopped buying it. Honestly, I don't understand how I ever liked it. I mean, it's just okay. Mix all the cheeses together. And I'm going to put the cream cheese in last because it's still warm from softening it. I'm going to go ahead and put some of this. Huh?
Katie?
Yeah.
Close the door.
It's not facing the bathroom. It's facing me. You don't have to close the door. Can't even hear you from here. So I'm gonna leave just a little bit. Cheese for topping on salad or something. I'm gonna use that for salad. Okay. I'm gonna put some parmesan. Okay, so this is cool. I'm going to go ahead and put this in there. And then the oven is ready. So, and the cheese mix is just about ready. I can't believe I didn't add sour cream. I'm putting this in here. It's my last thing. So. It's nice and creamy now. Okay. Okay, so we're just going to mix this up. This all mixed up. And it's going to give you like almost a cheese paste kind of thing. That's what you want. That's what you're looking for. Alright. So this is ready to go. Noodles are ready to go. Meat is ready to go, and so we're just going to assemble. I'm going to spray the pan first. Try not one across on the set the pan up here. That's where we're going to be putting it all together in this pan right here. So I think I could probably fit this. This will be fun right here.
with the meat.
Two of these here on the bottom. Just spread that out a bit.
Just to coat the bottom.
Yeah, you can see okay. I think you can see okay, yeah.
Well, my phone might go ahead and overheat. Who knows? In the 8 minutes I want to film this.
Alright. So we're ready for
the noodles. And we're going to lay some noodles out flat.
See how they fit the pan perfectly? That's what I want.
That. Okay. Now we're going to put a layer of cheese. So what you want to do is you want to kind of just try and spread it around. So you're not using too much of the cheese in one layer.
That's something. Sorry.
Excuse me.
Felt a little pin prick. It was one of those tag things that you get on your shirt.
Little end.
Yeah,
that. So we're just going to put like little spoonfuls like this. So then it will melt in the oven. All nice mixed together. That'll be good. I just want to spread it around. Don't put too much at a time down, but work quickly as well. The oven is not preheated yet, but it's getting there. What are you doing? Don't want to be in the bathroom with Daddy anymore? Because I'm cooking, is that the deal? I need you to go and get some more of this. No. Maybe, maybe not. Maybe, maybe. Okay. There we are. Got a nice little layer there. Okay, some noodles. Again. And cheese again. Spread out pretty good. Spread it out pretty good. Get the whole thing coated.
I don't know how I'm going to stop this from doing what it's doing, but
anyway, so we're just finishing the cheese layer here. That would be a little bit for the top there. So we're going to spread this as much as we can. Nice cheese layer spread out a little bit.
melting because the meat is still warm.
I'm melting.
All right. So we've got that food spread out. And we're going to take the
noodles again.
The meat in there. Another layer. This thick meat layer. Push it all down in the pan. Not too hard, but yeah. Push it down in there. This is going to be the last meat layer, so then we'll have one more noodle and then cheese layer on top. I hope we have enough cheese left for that. So we pretty much want to use all the meat on this last layer. He didn't fall. I didn't think about that. Just a second. I don't think he fell. I'm not hearing no springs. Alright, so the meat layer is done. And we've got one more noodle layer here. Thin as I can, because there's not a lot of cheese left. That's like really not a lot of cheese left. But we're gonna make it. Is I'm running out of time, but we're gonna make it work here. So we're just spreading the last cheese layer on top. This will be the top of the casserole. And we've used not quite all the noodles. Maybe they put extra in there for the ones that are hard or something. I'm gonna need to get the spatula to get every drop.
I need a spatula. I got a spatula. I have a clean spatula.
Every drop of this cheese on this because we are running low, and now I have that extra that I didn't put in here, thankfully, that I can sprinkle right on top. And we're going to put foil on it in the oven at 375 for about an hour, and then we're going to check it. And then, but you can cook it for up to like an hour and a half if you wanted to. But it's going to be in there for like an hour. And unfortunately, I fell asleep and didn't wake up like I was supposed to. I was just closing my eyes for a minute. And I had my alarm set for 6. I think I actually got up at 6:30. We do have enough, just enough for the city. Got just enough cheese. So we got a nice little layer of spread here. And we got every drop of the cheese on here. every single drop. Okay. And now we're almost there. Oh my goodness, I got seconds before I get shut off again. I don't know how I'm gonna get more room on. Almost here. Okay, so we're gonna sprinkle this on top. And I think that we saved it because there we go. Tinfoil. I'm splicing this together because I don't care. We're going to put tinfoil over the top, and the oven is preheated. And I got a mess going into my kitchen today. So what I'm going to do here is, oh yeah, so we put it in the oven for 1 hour. Got the timer set. Thank you for joining me in making lasagna. Got to splice the film together, but we're gonna make it work. So 17 seconds. Please like, subscribe, hit the bell notification. And so yeah, click the all bell notification so you can get notified every time I want to make a fool of myself. So here we are again.